It's time once again to interview a coach on the Sports Couch Show, brought to you by People's National Bank, serving you with locations throughout Southern Illinois, member FDIC and equal housing lender, and by Mount Vernon Title Company. When you need title work or real estate closings or contract for deed work, Mount Vernon Title Company. During week 9, the final week of the regular season in high school football, the Fairfield Mules traveled down to Vienna for a Saturday afternoon game. They wrapped up the regular season with a convincing 70-6 win at Vienna. And the good news is the Mules finished the regular season 6-3, and now they're going to get to play in week number 10 as they've made it to the playoffs. And with us is Coach Justin Townsend of the Mules, and that is the big thing, is that you wrap up the regular season 6-3 and you get to play in week 10, and there's a lot of teams that don't get to do that, Coach.
Yeah, I mean, there's, I don't know the exact number, but there's, probably around 300 schools sitting at home right now not playing, and we get to be together for another week and hopefully maybe more after that. So, we're excited. I think everybody's goal when they go into a season, definitely one of them is to be a playoff team. Mm-hmm. And that's definitely one of ours year in and year out. I think it's just an expectation, and I think people take it for granted, but this year, I think we learned more than any other year here recently that you can't do that. You gotta go out and you gotta play the games and you gotta prepare, and things are gonna happen and you're gonna have adversity, and our kids have persevered though, and we've battled through, and we kind of got to a point where we felt really good about our last four games and felt like this is a position we could be in. Then it was just kind of a matter of whether we fell into, 2A or 3A, and, kind of an odd year where if we were 3A, we'd probably be hosting a game right now, as odd as that seems. Mm-hmm. But, we're 2A for, I think, the second time ever. So I think we're actually the biggest 2A team. And, we're going to go on the road up north to North Mac High School. So got a beautiful facility up there, just a couple of years old, and they're 8-1. Very, very good football team, obviously. Their only loss is to Pena, week 8.
Yeah, and I think looking at their stats, I think they've only given up like 84 points all season or something.
Yeah, and I think half of those were to Pena, week 8. Probably, so to kind of give you an idea, I think they gave up to Pena 41-42 points week 8, which that was actually, it was a 41-42-14 ball game, and North Mac scored late, like last play or two to make it 42-21. So, I didn't realize it. North Mac actually came over from the Saginaw conference this year. Mm-hmm.
They're in the South Central Conference with Vandalia and Staunton and some of those teams you've played before.
We're familiar with that conference. And, I don't know what the reasoning behind all that
was. Somebody dropped out.
Yeah, somebody dropped out. I think Roxanna dropped out, created an opening, but I'm not sure what the reasoning for getting out of the Saginaw was. It's a closed conference, so it's, it's kind of like you don't really know what you got. Now I would say, based on some of the things that I've seen, I don't know that their conference is as strong as it has been, but definitely Pena and North Mac are really, really good. We're going to have to play really, really good football to upset them. But we're not happy just being in the playoffs. We've kind of grown accustomed to winning our round one playoff game. And that's how we've been preparing this week. And that's the approach we're taking with our kids. We feel like we're playing our best football right now. That's something that, we feel like we finally got the pieces in place and we could go up there and give them everything we got.
For some people who don't know where North Mac High School is, that's Virden, Illinois, which is up towards Springfield. So that's about a 2.5-hour track up there, something like that.
About 2 hours, 45 minutes. Some of the Fairfield people may remember that's where Coach Ron Graham left Fairfield back in the early 90s and went up to Virden. Back before Virden and I believe it's Girard came together and formed North Mac High School. So it used to be just two small 1A schools up there, and now they're together and make North Mac High School. So, I mentioned the facilities. I mean, you get on their school website, they're unbelievable. Not just their football, but their baseball and softball fields. And you know, it's going to be neat for our kids. It's, you know, we, you know, 2 hours and 45 minutes is a long haul. Mm-hmm. I mean, we probably have one of the longer trips. You know, when you go 5-4 and 6-3 and, mm-hmm. you know, most of the time you're going to be on the road. Right. You're probably going to have a little traveling. Although, you know, we thought, you know, had Carmi been able to win Friday, mm-hmm. you know, Flora upset them. I think we would have been at Carmi mm-hmm. had everything played out. So, yep. You know, we could have had a really close trip.
Yeah.
But on the other end of it, now we're 2 hours and 45 minutes away. But
well, I'm sure you've been looking at some game film. So yeah. what do you know about North Mac so far?
I think the first thing that will probably jump out at you is number 69 on their O-line, D-line. He's a Vanderbilt commit.
Oh, wow.
Going there, you know, playing the SEC, obviously.
That's pretty amazing coming out of yeah. school that small yeah. to be a D1 player.
Yeah. He had had some and I'm sorry, I look at the numbers. I don't necessarily look at the names, mm-hmm. but you won't miss him. Mm-hmm. About 6'5", 320. He had some smaller D1 offers, and I kind of read up on him a little bit, and I think he had put some things out on Twitter. And obviously, I think he's pretty strong academically for Vanderbilt to mm-hmm. snatch him up. But I think he was an All-Stater last mm-hmm. year, so he's a nice player. Very, very, very senior lad and team. I think they only have 4 or 5 juniors even on their roster.
Wow.
And so a lot of seniors playing both ways. I don't even know that they really play any sophomores. Mm-hmm. And they mix and match a few of the juniors, but it's mostly seniors, and they were, you know, a 5-5 team last year. Nice quarterback. He's probably more of a runner. And he can run. They have good speed on the outside. Kind of a number 41, be a good linebacker for him. Running back, hard nose type kid. He's about 215 pounds. Runs downhill. They'll run multiple formations. You know, we sat down as a staff and started charting formations, and we almost got to a point where we just stopped because it was so many of them. And then, you know, you don't want to overwhelm your kids with. You know, certain different numbers of formations and alignments and things like that. So, you know, we try to keep our defensive game plans as short as, you know, as simple as possible so they can go out and play. It makes a few minor adjustments. So that's what we're doing, you know. But, you know, I mentioned the big offensive and defensive linemen. But then after that, I think size-wise, you know, they're just your average mm-hmm. football team size-wise. But, like I said, very senior-dominated team. And I do think that they feel like maybe this is their year, mm-hmm. You know, they're definitely going to be tough out in the playoffs. I think Payne surprised them a little bit. Mm-hmm. You know, this was their first year in this conference, and when they played each other, Payne was undefeated, or maybe had lost once. I think maybe mm-hmm. already to Vandalia way back
early in the year. Yeah,
so. And that game was at Pena, and mm-hmm. that's a film we watched. And I kind of feel like Pena had kind of been prepping for that game all year because mm-hmm. some of the things they did offensively, it mm-hmm. just everything was working that night, you know. Yeah. And I think North Mac mm-hmm. maybe a little shell-shocked. Mm-hmm. They hadn't really been tested or had anything like that. So, you know, Pena was another school we thought we might get. And, you know, just a matter of, I think, 1 point, mm-hmm. you know, differential from us getting Pena, too. So, you know, I don't think that they're, you know, Pena is so much better than them. You know, that score is kind of not indicative, in my opinion. They're both very good in that conference. But I think their conference is similar to our Black mm-hmm. Diamond. I think, you know, I mentioned the closed conference. You just you don't quite know what you're getting mm-hmm. until you get out, you know.
Right.
And, you know, I'll put it out there. I think Johnston City's a pretty good football team.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I think Carmi's a pretty good football team. I think Cesar's a pretty good football team. I think we're a pretty good football team. So I think we proved that last year, and I'm kind of anxious to see how things go this year.
Yeah. Well, as you sit here and talk about how, you know, you want to try to stop North Mac and their skilled people, they're sitting there, they got to figure out how to stop you, too.
Yeah, I mean.
Because part of this is you don't want to beat yourself.
No, and that's a big part of it. I mean, you know, we try to – I do know some coaches in that conference, and, you know, I'm like, you know, what films do we want? Mm-hmm. And And they're like, well, nobody does what you guys do. Yeah. You know, it's going to be hard for them to replicate that. And
exactly.
And so we always feel like that's something we have a little bit in our favor, you know, and that can be a blessing and that can be a curse, because at the same time, you know, we're very run heavy offense or conference. And, you know, when you get a team like North Mac, who they are very run heavy, but they do it a different way. You know, there are a lot of sideline to sideline type stuff, jet sweep and misdirection with the quarterback, and then the next thing you know, they're downhill. You know, so they do it a lot of different ways. Whereas, you know, Carmine and Fairfield and Johnston City is, you know,
we're straight ahead,
right. And we're gonna, you know, hit you in the mouth, and so, you know, that can go both ways. Mm-hmm. But you know, we're hoping that, you know, you mentioned not beating yourself. You know, penalties, turnovers. Sustaining drives. You know, I go back to our Carmine game, our first drive. You know, it was 6-7 minute drive, grinding it out, 3-5 yards.
Your offense becomes your defense,
right? And driving it down and scoring. Those are the types of drives when you go on the road in the playoffs that you got to have. And if you can come out and do that a couple times in the first half, it instantly puts that opposing team offense kind of, you know, okay, you know, we're going to press a little bit. Maybe we got to do something, get out of our comfort zone a little bit.
Right.
And, you know, that's a couple of things I've already hit on with our team. You know, that and playoff time, that's the type of drives you're going to have, period. Because, you know, everybody's good defensively. Everybody's prepared. They've seen you. You're going to have to earn it, and everybody's got a few wrinkles here or there. And when you take those shots, you got to execute them too. Right. And so, you know, obviously it's week 10. We're excited to be here and see what we can do. Yep. You know, we talked about it with our kids. This is an opportunity for us to set ourselves apart a little bit from, you know, teams in the past. We've only won one playoff road game ever. 2009, we beat Brees Central on the road, 30-0. So you know, that's something that hadn't been done a lot here at Fairfield. So just another challenge that, you know, hopefully we can step up and do.
You know, and looking back at that game against Brees Central, I'd forgot about that. I don't think you were favored in that game either. I think they were heavily favored, and you kept them scoreless.
They were heavily favored, and I don't think we were really respected at all, quite frankly. And I mean, we went over there and just flat out whipped them, quite frankly, and then lost round two to Greenville.
Greenville, right?
You know, from the SCC conference,
right.
And you know, I think we probably win that game if Cameron Williams doesn't go out with a ankle sprain. I think we lost. I don't know, 29-21, something like that. You know, I think we ran a halfback pass or something and got a shoestring tackle, maybe from a chance of having a 2-point conversion. So, you know, but so, you know, that's just another challenge for our kids, and, you know, kind of putting it out there. And, you know, our kids will respond. We're going to play hard. That's never been an issue with our kids. They leave it all out on the field. So,
how about special teams? Does North Mac have much of a kicking game at all?
Well, you know, they've been pretty explosive offensively, so you haven't seen much. But they struggle a little bit punting the football. But, you know, it's something they don't have to do a lot. They do kick extra points, but it's not something that they are super strong at, you know. So a lot of times they'll just go for two. So, no, I don't think – and a lot of times you get up there in Central Illinois and the wind is just brutal. You know, so I don't know – how much of it? Now they do have a kid that can kick it to about the five, you know. So, but once again, the wind can neutralize that pretty effectively.
Well, Coach, again, congratulations on the win at Vienna, finishing the regular season 6-3, and best of luck up there at North Mac in round one of the playoffs.
Okay, thank you.